At 6'3 and 290 pounds, Ed Oliver may quietly just be the best defensive player entering the 2019 NFL draft, and he's been a household name since he stepped foot on the University of Houston's campus. Oliver was a five-star prospect in high school and decided to stay home and attend the University of Houston, where his elite ability on the field transferred well on the collegiate level. He declared for this year's NFL draft at the beginning of last season, where he finished with 54 tackles and 14.5 TFLs and 3 sacks just in 8 games, and he finishes his career as a Cougar, a 3-time first-team All-American. Now, Oliver's athleticism and raw talent at the defensive tackle position has made him such a valuable prospect, but the one thing that has some NFL scouts and coaches concerned is his size. Battling some of those bigger interior offensive linemen in the NFL, they don't know if that same athleticism that he used in college will transfer well over on the next level, but I personally think it will. Now, in this version of the breakdown, we'll take a complete look at Ed Oliver's pros and cons.
To Mixon out in space. But man, again, Ed Oliver, the 300-pounder out there covering a running back on a swing.
As I mentioned earlier, Oliver's athleticism is off the charts for an interior defensive lineman. When we usually think of D-tackles, we think of big guys there to clog up the holes and keep the lineman off the linebackers, well, a la Vince Wilfork, those type of guys. But Oliver's first step may already be faster and more dangerous than some NFL vets, and he reminds me a lot of the quickness off the line possessed by Jadeveon Clowney. Now, this allows him to ruin blocking schemes by beating his initial block and also beating pulling linemen to the mesh point. A lot of the times, if you look at his highlight tape, you'll see a guard pulling, but Oliver is already in the backfield just destroying the play. Every play, he may not make the tackle, but he causes so much garbage in that backfield, the running back really has nowhere to go, which makes an easy play for his linebackers. He also has great flexibility, which of course is important for playing the position, and especially in the trenches, which allows him to make huge plays off the cross blitzes due to his ability to bend tight corners and get to the quarterback. If you look at some of Houston's tape, a lot of their blitzes were twists and turns that Oliver is great at because his hips and his flexibility, he's able to bend those corners and get to the quarterback. Another thing that stands out about Ed Oliver is his effort. There are some things that you just can't coach, and one of those things are great effort, in my opinion. You either have it or you don't, and Ed Oliver definitely has one of the highest motors in all of college football. A lot of times opposing offenses run away from Oliver, but that still hasn't kept him from disrupting plays by chasing them down from behind, which is sometimes 20 yards down the field. Now, seeing a defensive lineman, let alone a defensive tackle, chasing down a running back down the field is incredible to watch. But Ed Oliver's athleticism, sometimes you forget he's a defensive tackle. He plays a lot like a linebacker, and that's why I think that him being a little undersized won't matter that much once he gets into the NFL. Now, I hate to make comparisons so early, but this kid reminds me a lot of Aaron Donald. He may not be as strong as Aaron Donald. I'm not going to say he's just going to come into the league and just be a Pro Bowler off rip, but he has that ability. When you look at Aaron Donald, and some of the moves he makes on these offensive linemen and just to get off the blocks, that's the same thing we see from Ed Oliver. But one thing that Oliver does better than Aaron Donald is he has one of the highest motors in all of football, and that's just something that you can't coach. And as a former linebacker, I love to see defensive tackles like that, because when you got 11 guys running to the ball, literally from your defensive tackle to your safety, you're going to have a great team. And I think that's what Ed Oliver can bring to a lot of NFL teams. He's going to bring a lot of athleticism to your defensive line. He's going to change the way you call defensive plays, and it's going to make some defensive coordinator very happy, I'm sure. Another thing Oliver is great at is penetrating and his pass rush ability. When combining his elite first step and those moves that he has off the line, a lot of times it's just raw athleticism and raw talent. But I think with good NFL coaching, and once he gets his hands better and gets some better defensive lineman moves and just get better at his technique, I think he's going to be an unstoppable force. I think Ed Oliver may be one of the better players entering this draft offensively and defensively. But one thing that may be looked at by a few of the scouts and coaches is the situation that he had in Houston with former head coach Major Applewhite. If we remember, Oliver decided to sit out for the bowl game as he prepared for the upcoming NFL draft. And there was a moment during that bowl game where Major Applewhite asked Oliver to remove a coat because he wasn't playing. And we remember seeing Oliver snapping off on the coach, and remember them talking about it in the post game. Now, those goals to character issues. Now, when we think about NFL scouting, when we think about the NFL draft, we think all about combine numbers. We think about film, but these guys also look at player character. Now, I don't think that one moment is going to define Ed Oliver's character. I think he has a lot of people that can vouch for him and talk about his character as a person off the field, not just a player on the field. So I don't think that's going to hold him back, but there will be one thing to watch out for if we see him drop in the draft, which I doubt he will, and if he does, some team is going to be very, very lucky to grab him late. But I don't think that one issue there at Houston is going to hurt him too much. As soon as he stepped on the campus of the University of Houston, he was an All-American. One of his first games against Oklahoma, against Baker Mayfield and those guys, he played like no true freshman should, especially at the University of Houston, going up against some of the best offensive linemen in the country that the University of Oklahoma always has year in and year out. But going back to his size, we always hear guys talk about undersized players, and Ed Oliver may not be your prototypical defensive tackle, but that's one of the things that I think makes him special. I think that his athleticism, his size, allows him the ability to make some plays that some of the bigger defensive tackles don't have that ability to make. But some of the cons of being undersized, like I said earlier, in the NFL, you're going to get some of the best interior offensive linemen in the world, and all teams have some great guards, great centers, and sometimes I think on double teams it might be easy to move Oliver around unless he puts on a little bit of weight, get a little stronger, and able to hold his own against those big guys. But ultimately, at the end of the day, I think drafting Ed Oliver is going to be a plus for any team, more so than it will hurt the team. I think it's going to help those guys, defensive line, him coming in and maybe not immediately being able to help, but I think he can. But I think, like I said, with great coaching and some great mentoring from some of those vets, whoever drafts him, I think Ed Oliver is going to be a name that we'll be hearing for a long time. Now, guys, I hope you enjoyed this analysis of Ed Oliver. We're going to have more defensive players coming in soon, and we really appreciate you guys, all the support you've given us so far. But make sure you like, subscribe, and share to the channel. Tell a friend to tell a friend, and make sure you follow us on Twitter as well at the Gridiron Soapbox. We'll be starting our website pretty soon, and we'll have more defensive guys going on. We've seen you guys enjoying all of the offensive guys we've been putting out. Shouts out to my partner Jeremy Whitlow. He's been doing a great job, and guys, we're just going to keep it coming. We want to hear from you. Make sure you leave some comments in the session. Who you want to hear us talk about next? What do you think about Ed Oliver? Do you think he's going to make an immediate impact in the league? Do you think he's going to be one of those guys that we're still talking about 10 years from now? Will he be one of those draft picks that changes the culture of a team? I think he has that ability, but is his character going to hold him back? We can only wait and see. Now, the combine is next week. We're excited to see how those guys do. But guys, once again, thanks for watching, and wait for the next video. It'll be here before you know it.